The Spanish Film Club series was made possible with the support of PREGDA, the Secretary of the State for Culture of Spain, and its Program for Cultural Cooperation with the United States Universities. Hello everyone! Welcome to the Nipissing University Spanish Film Festival. Tonight is the special viewing of Karim Ainouz's and Marcelo Gomez's I Travel Because I Have To, I Come Back Because I Love You, a Latin American film that was presented in 2009 with the original title Viaje Porque Precis, Volte Porque Te Amo. It follows a geologist who travels to northeastern Brazil to survey watercourses for a new canal. However, as the film progresses, we start to learn more about the narrator's personal life than we do about his geological work.
The film's language is mainly Portuguese, and it runs with a film time of 75 minutes total. Before we get into the style of the film and the themes portrayed, Sean is going to just go over a brief history of the setting of the film and some history that may also be incorporated with it.
This film takes place in the beautiful and yet unforgiving territory of northeastern Brazil, with all of its riverways and water sources that leak out into the South Atlantic Ocean. The three main rivers that pierce through this hot climate are the Rio Jaguaribe, the Rio Paranas, and the Rio San Francisco, with only the Rio San Francisco staying flooded all year round. My assumption is that the film captures the Rio Jaguaribe, which dries out predominantly for the year, and goes through the scrublands of the Sertão, which are the majority of the filming was done. This area has a changing climate of rainy wet periods in the spring season, and then an extremely dry climate for the rest of the year, reaching up to 38 degrees Celsius, and sometimes even higher. The film captures a semi-arid region along the coastline of the South Atlantic, with short and shrubby vegetation and free-roaming animals. The climate itself is very similar to eastern and central Australia, with similar biolife and creatures, some of which to name are the jackrabbit, the desert bighorn sheep, and the pronghorned antelope. The history of this area is particularly rich with discovery, as it was the first area that the Portuguese landed on in April 22, 1500. More specifically in the state of Bahia, under the command of Pedro Alvares Cabral, a Portuguese settler. The city of Salvador Bahia became the unofficial colonial capital of Brazil, with large amounts of African slaves imported in and other resources exported out, such as sugar and rich minerals, until 1763, when the Rio de Janeiro became the new economic power of Brazil. The history and geography of Brazil sets the context of the film and is constantly referenced through the use of cinematic techniques.
As with Latin American films in general, I Travel Because I Have To is not like the typical films we see coming out of Hollywood. Latin American cinema often uses non-actors. They do not necessarily have clear plots. They may be slow-paced, they have different styles of editing, and they commonly do not have happy endings.
Finito placer sin igual. Por siempre juntos los dos. Vida juntos ya como es.
There are several underlying themes throughout the movie. One of the more prominent themes is the one of loneliness, love, and loss. The imagery, tone, music, the narration, and the continued use of the movie's title, Viage pour que précise, volte pour que tu aimes, all contribute to the overall feeling of isolation and sadness. One of the Latin American undertones is the one of deep poverty. Northeastern Brazil has a high rural population, which includes a great deal of impoverished residents. 35% of the population is in poverty due to the unsophisticated water systems and the impenetrable geography. Many northeastern Brazilians, especially women, are forced to supplement their urban incomes through other means, such as prostitution. When the narrator arrives at this point in his journey, many North American viewers may be quick to judge his morals. However, those who are immersed in the study of Latin American culture may know that this behavior is not necessarily as morally condemned in Latin American culture as it is in North America. These undertones of the culture become prominent as we follow the narrator on his journey of love, loss, and loneliness. This film includes several aspects that might be shocking to viewers of traditional North American films. Editing and cinematography contains dizzying shots, it uses photographic montages, many images of just the road as the narrator speaks, and it has sudden cuts from movement to a still shot of a nature scene. The overall film style may leave some of you puzzled, but this is all intentional. The filmmakers have used these techniques to tell the story of confusion and loneliness, and it is through these methods that the true story begins to unravel. The meaning of the title of the film also plays a role in our understanding of the story. Its meaning begins to change as we travel along inside the narrator's mind. I Travel Because I Have To demands a thoughtful and analytical viewing. The filmmakers and the narrator do not give us all the information we need to follow the story, unlike what we would experience in our own North American films. As you're watching, you may think, there's something there, but I'm not quite sure what that is. But it's up to us as viewers to determine what that there-ness is. We encourage you to stick around after the film and tell us what you thought. Films aren't just about the viewing process, but about sharing your thoughts, feelings, confusions, and anything you liked or disliked about the film. So now, on behalf of Pregda and everyone from Nipissing University and Kenner College who have made this film festival possible, we would like to present I Travel Because I Have To, I Come Back Because I Love You.